So hello and welcome back to my channel Armor Crawl. In today's video I'm going to compare my brand new LG CX 65 inch OLED with my 3-year old Samsung KU6300 LCD. And before we start with this, I am going to say something. So I know in my last video I mentioned that this was part one from the testing and calibration, and probably a couple of you guys, people expecting the part two, and it's coming soon, but I need a little bit more time with the calibration because I recently started to playing around on this TV with the auto calibration function in combination with Karman, and this takes longer than expected. So just give me a couple of more days and I will give you the second part, and I would say we dive right in with comparing those two TVs, and we start with the uniformity test. So for the uniformity test, we starting with a 50% grayscale test pattern, and also what you can see when I show you the 55 inch Samsung, the reflections over there. So that's how the coating is on the TV. So it's not bad actually, but let's focus on the uniformity, and you can see a lot of dark areas around the screen. So luckily there's almost nothing in the middle of the screen, which is very good for watching sports or playing game. But you can see it's not even. So let's move over to the OLED. What you can see here on the bottom is a little bit of a dark spot, which is, thanks God, not noticeable, or I can't see it at all in movement or in real-time pictures. So the rest is, even it looks a little bit weird on the camera, but I can assure you there's a couple of very minor lines here probably, but this is all very minor. The most major part is really on the bottom here, but which is also, it looks more, much more on the camera than in real, to be honest. And here you can see actually a different color temperature as well. So both of the TVs are in game mode at the moment. Uncalibrated standard settings, and you can also already see there's a different color temperature. Okay, let's move on to a different test picture. So now we're looking at a 30% grayscale, and I'm doing a couple of tests later on with the lights off because it's getting really hard to see stuff on the screen with all the reflections on the LCD. The OLED is a little bit better, but still you can see me. But you can see the LCD is really on the, especially on the edges, really worse here. And here again the OLED. So this bottom part, it looks really weird on the camera. I don't know how it looks at your screen at home, but if I'm looking without the camera, I can't see anything. So it looks like the camera is really making more out of it. Okay, moving on to color pictures. Okay, we're starting with 100% red, and both of them looking really good. So I can't see any issue on the OLED. But again, I don't know if you can see it on your screen. The edges on the LCD, especially this corner here, and all the part up here to the top is suffering from dirty screen effect. Okay, let's move to green. Okay, so now we have in green color. Which again, can't see any big issue on the OLED and the same issue on the LCD like before. So, and last but not, sorry, least but not last, no, last but not least, oh my god, sorry for that. Here the blue one, which has a minor difference in the color, in the blue temperature, in the, you can see it. But that's okay. So overall for, so overall I have to say for really for a low budget TV, so this was around $1,200 3 years ago, compared to this $4,500 OLED. This one makes a really, really good picture on the uniformity. Because if you compare, you can buy three times this TV. Okay, it's just a 55 inch, but anyway. Okay, so I would say we're moving on to motion test. Okay, so here we are with my favorite motion test, one you can find on the internet, the UFO ghosting test. And I showed you this in the last video already. And there's a big, big difference. So OLED has a really almost a perfect motion or response time from the panel, which on the other hand, this VA panel is again suffering from ghosting. And I would say we start right in with this one, and I'm just trying to give you, if I'm following this UFO, just starting again, just give me a second, you can see the ghosting and the blurring. And we're doing the same on the old LED at the moment. So can you see there's nothing, really there's nothing. I just want to do it again here, OLED. Perfect. And here the LCD. And here a lot of ghosting, blurring on the LCD and nothing at all on the OLED. And this is what I can see in the gaming as well. So both TVs are right now are set up at 4K 60Hz. And this OLED, as you know, is capable of 120Hz, which means 120 frames per second at maximum. And this is just such a big difference. As you know, probably a couple of you guys know, I'm owning a gaming monitor, which a VA panel and 144Hz. And comparing this monitor, which is a little bit better than this screen, the LCD, but even this 144Hz, because it's a VA panel, it doesn't look as good as this one in 60Hz. That's just my opinion. But if I compare gaming 60Hz 4K material here on this one, from the just from the motion, from the movement, it looks in my opinion better than on the 1440p panel with 144Hz, because of the blurring, because of the ghosting. So things, moving objects are not as sharp as on this TV with just 60 frames or 60Hz. Okay. For the next, I would say we're going to some real gaming tests to show you, probably, hopefully I can show you the ghosting on the camera, because it's a little bit tricky with camera and YouTube, but let's move on to some gaming tests. So for the gaming test, I chose the game Divinity Original Sin Part 2, and no worries about spoiler alarms or something like this. This is the very beginning of the game, so don't worry about this. And I also like to have a look on the overall picture quality from both of the TVs. So both of the TVs are running 4K 60 frames at the moment, and both are in game mode, not calibrated, standard settings, maximum brightness, and that's the difference. So what I can tell you is, I mean, the camera will make it look differently probably, and YouTube as well, but what I can see is a much better contrast on the OLED, thanks to the perfect black level. The LCD, on the other hand, looks too bright in my opinion. If you look at this a little bit closer, I mean, you can see all the details, that's fine, But this is just too bright, especially here in this corner. If you compare this with the OLED, this is so much nicer, this picture on the OLED, to be honest. And what I like to show you is, especially when you have a look now on those objects. I hope you can see this when I start moving the camera around. I'm just trying to get both TVs in the picture. And I'm not sure, oh, you can clearly see it. So if you look at this particular spot here on the LCD and the same on the OLED, when I'm starting to move the picture. Can you see this? This is ghosting. This is VA panel. It can't handle dark objects moving as good as the OLED. There's nothing at all at the OLED, but a very big problem on the LCD. The whole picture, if you watch really closely, is going darker in the dark objects, because that's really because the ghosting or the response time from the panel is too low to refresh the picture in the dark areas. That's why all the dark areas are blurring out to one piece of dark spot or whatever. I don't know how to explain in English, to be honest. But this is what you can see. That's the result from a VA panel. And it's very clear here. And we'll have a look on the OLED. And there's nothing at all. Nothing at all. It's the same result what you can see on the UFO test. UFO. So that's why, in my opinion, since I own this OLED, I would never touch a VA panel again for gaming. Never. This is so obvious at the moment. Look at this. And this is for every game. It's not just this game. This is just a very good example, in my opinion, where I noticed this very, very clearly. And here again, the OLED. No problems at all. Okay, so we're going to our next game. We're going to play FIFA on the PlayStation 4, and let's see how this looks like. Okay, so here we are with FIFA 19. And actually, I'm not playing because I just have one hand free, because I need to hold the camera. So I will let the computer play, and I will leave you with the impression here with the two different screens. They both look really, really good at the moment. So maybe probably the OLED is a little bit more vivid in the colors, which to be honest, I'm not sure if this is right or not, because both of the TVs are not calibrated. So it can be right, can be wrong. But so far I would say I can't see a big difference between both of the TVs. Even there's a big difference in terms of money wise. Okay, let's move on to the game. Here we are. Game starts. And let's focus on the LCD first. That's really good picture, really, to be honest. And the good thing is there's, in FIFA, there's not much or not many dark objects. So the ghosting is not a big problem in this sort of game. But I still can see when the ball is very, very fast. I can see a little bit of a trail behind the ball. It's probably not visible for you on your screen. But to be honest, for this kind of game on the LCD at the moment, looks very nice. I'm just trying to focusing on the background at the moment to make sure I don't miss anything before I go over to the OLED, which we're doing now. And this also looks very, very nice. And now there's no trail behind the ball on this screen. Not at all. So again, the motion handling on the OLED is far better than on the LCD. But again, for this sort of game, it's not a big deal, because there are no dark objects on the screen and it's a very bright game. And even in the background, I'm trying to see something on the LCD or here. On the LCD, I can notice here when all the people are moving, then the picture also getting darker and brighter again when it stops. So this is exactly the same again. The ghosting, it's very hard to see on the camera, to be honest. Oh, now you can see it. If you focus on this, I'm going a little bit closer. It's very hard to see on the camera. It's very obvious if you don't look at the camera. And the same again with here, the OLED. There's nothing at all on this. All the people are just having the same brightness all the time compared to the LCD over there. It's hard to see, but it's there as well. It's the same like in the other game, but not as visible as in the other game, of course. But if you look very closely, you can see it. And that's the problem. What I'm talking about the bad motion, about the bad response time from a VA panel compared to an OLED. Okay, let's move on to movies. Okay, so before we move on to movies now, I have forgotten something to tell in the game testing, and it's input lag. So input lag on this LCD TV with 60 Hertz is around 20 milliseconds, more or less 20 milliseconds, 19 point something. And I think RTX measured this one as, correct me if I'm wrong, I will have a look later on, I think about 14 milliseconds with 60 Hertz and around 8 or 7 point something milliseconds and 120 Hertz. And during the 60 Hertz, 60 frame gaming, I didn't notice any difference, to be honest. So it's hard. I mean, we're talking about, let's say, 4 or 5 milliseconds. I barely can't tell there's a difference, you know. But when I played this one in 120 hertz, I definitely saw a difference from the input lag and from the mouse reaction and stuff like this. So keep this also in mind for gaming. 120 hertz and 8 milliseconds input lag is impressive. Okay, but now we're moving on to movies. So before we start now the movie or the demo video, I'd like to show you the black level from the LCD, which is very hard to capture it on the camera, to be honest. But this is the OLED, and you can see my camera is doing a lot of noise and it's hard to focus. But it looks, in real time, it looks really, really raw. So the OLED is deep black. So, of course, it's an OLED, and the LCD is just gray. So, but anyway, let me start this movie, and yeah, just enjoy. All Oh my god, this is so much better on the OLED. This is, there's no, this is so unfair against the LCD, really. And it's actually on the camera, it looks much better than in real. The LCD is just gray in this. The colors are not too bad, to be honest, compared to the OLED, but because this is a demo movie, demo video from LG, and of course it covers the black levels from their OLEDs. And this is just, it's really on the camera, it's not even half worse what you can, what I can see in real life. The LCD has no chance in this video clip against the OLED. Not at all. And of course in a dark room. When we turn on the light, it's different. This is so much better on the OLED. Really. Colors are much better on the OLED. And of course, the superb black level. Okay, let me turn on the light. Okay, so that's for the comparison in a dark room. And now we just have a quick look on the same screen, on the same clip again, in a bright room, which also again, you can see the much better mirroring handling or reflection handling on the OLED. But again, this is, no. So even in a bright room, because of the much better reflection handling from the OLED, can you see the carpet there? You can't see any carpet from the, on the OLED. And here the carpet on the LCD is very obvious. So even in a bright room, the OLED is much, much better at the moment. Colors are not too bad, but again, OLED colors are much, much better. Okay, so I think that's for the comparison so far. If you have any ideas or if you like to see more comparison between those TVs or even a 3 years 1080p LCD 55 inch, which to be honest, it's a very unfair comparison against the OLED LED, then just write me a comment in the section, and I hope you had fun. And what I like to say in the conclusion or summary for this video. So if you're going to ask me, hey, should I buy this OLED? Then I would say it depends. So it depends what content you are watching. So if you're just watching news, you're coming home, you turn on the TV, you're watching news, you don't need a $4,500 OLED. Just go with a LCD, because nowadays this is 3 years old. So the LCDs now are a bit better. But if on the other hand, your content is gaming, is movie, especially in dark rooms, there's at the moment, my opinion, no way around an OLED. I'm not saying it's a LG, because the Sony OLEDs are very good as well. Probably in movie, a bit better than the LG. But keep in mind that the Sonys have a very high input lag. I think around 24 milliseconds. I will double check this before I say something wrong. But yeah, what else to say? And also, if you watch just content in a very bright room, in a very bright room, you lose the capability from this OLED about the black levels almost. And remember, in a very bright room, LCD can be much more brighter. So funny thing about this can be around 450 candela, and this can be around 130 candela on a full white picture, but you haven't seen any difference because there's barely a full white picture on a movie to see or whatever. So the peak brightness on this TV is around, I think, 700 something kind of, which the peak brightness from this TV, I think it's just 450. So keep this also in mind. So that's from today. I think I covered all the mandatory things or the important things, and I'm actually a little bit surprised about still the performance from this 3-year-old TV, especially in some of the gaming and in some content from movies. So it's not as bad as I expected it. But anyway, so my personal favorite, of course, it's the OLED, because I like to game, and there's nothing better at the moment as this LG, because of the low input lag, perfect black level, and all this stuff. Okay, so thank you very much for watching me again. Please subscribe, and many thanks for all the viewers so far and for the subscribers, and I hope I can keep up with my good work. So I'm trying to do it, but as you know, I'm recently had a newborn baby, so it takes a lot of time. I'm also working, so don't expect too many videos. I'm trying to do a couple of videos probably per week, maybe 2 videos, but don't expect too much. Okay, I just started my channel, and yeah, let me try to do my best. And yeah, anyway, so if you like to see something in the future about comparison gaming, whatever, leave me a comment, and I'll see you next time. Bye.